Okay, hello everyone. So in the previous videos we have discussed about the combustion thermodynamics and the chemical equilibrium part. Now we will start the boundary layer theory. Before we start that, let me just revise few basics, which is the fluid mechanics stuff. If we recall the Navier-Stokes equation for a 2D steady incompressible flow with no body forces, you get the continuity equation as del dot u is 0. Or I can write it as dou u by dou x plus dou v by dou y equal to 0. And conservation of momentum, I can write something like this. Rho into u dot grad u minus equal to minus grad p plus mu Laplacian nu. Strictly speaking, you can write this in terms of index notation. Whatever way you are comfortable, you can use that. And in x direction, I can write something like rho into u dou u by dou x plus v dou u by dou y is minus dou p by dou x plus mu Laplacian of u. And in y direction, it is rho times u dou v by dou x plus v dou v by dou y equal to minus dou p by dou y plus mu times Laplacian of v. This is fine. But why we have to study boundary layer? Because first, for when we developed inviscid flow theory, we predicted that the lift is rho u gamma according to our Kutta-Joukowsky theorem, and this drag is equal to 0. But in real life, drag is not 0 because there is some viscous effect. And when this inviscid theory was developed, this viscous flow concept was not there. So they term this as D'Alembert's paradox. So for an inviscid flow, the flow of cylinder will be like this. But for a viscous flow, the for a viscous flow for large Reynolds number, there will be some vortices shedding out as shown here. Also, for this case, gamma is 0, so lift is also 0. But yeah, let's concentrate on drag part here. And if you notice the Cp, as predicted by this inviscid flow theory, we are getting something like 1 minus 3 sin squared theta. But in reality, till some angle, it is working perfectly. After that, it is deviating. Now, all this, we say that, okay, this is due to the friction. So we define few terms. One is due to the skin friction drag, or drag due to the tangential stress on the surface, and pressure drag due to the flow separation. You might have learned all these drag component terms in your aerodynamics course. And streamlined bodies, they will have more skin friction drag when compared to pressure drag, and bluff bodies have dominant pressure drag. Streamlined bodies, in the sense, you can take it as some airfoil. And bluff body, you can say it as a cylinder, or else maybe a flat plate which is perpendicular to flow, so that the flow, it will be almost like an inviscid flow outside the region, but here there will be some shedding vortices. Now, according to this, now we develop it viscous flow theory as Prandtl told. Prandtl told that the flow field can be divided into two parts. That is, a thin viscous zone near the wall. That is here, this is our viscous zone, and outside this viscous zone, our inviscid theory is applicable. Like, it's more accurate. So this thin viscous zone is called as boundary layer. So, okay, you are saying thin, but how thin? That thickness is defined by a term called boundary layer thickness. It is the distance perpendicular to solid body surface at which velocity is 99% of free stream velocity. Strictly speaking, this is an arbitrary number. Some people term it as 99, some people term it as 95, some people term it as 99.99. But standard convention followed by most of the people is 99. Anyways, why I'm saying 99 not exactly equal to free stream velocity is because it won't be. Like, the velocity will almost be like it will be equal to free stream velocity at infinity, you can say. Okay, till now we have discussed something related to the boundary layers. What is a boundary layer and the motivation? In the next video, we will see the mathematics of boundary layer. Thank you.